friends, welcome to Edu Skills OET Made Easy.
And today I'll be teaching you the strategies and tips for OET reading part C. My challenge is to make you fall in love with OET subtest reading. Let's get along.
I think most of you might have attended my sessions, previous sessions. Assume that you have attended A and B at lower, at least you have seen the video, because a lot of things will be assumed here. We'll not be going into those details. Staying with OET 2.0, Professional English Test Subtest Reading Part C. You can see my screen, right?
Yes, father. It's visible.
Yes, father. Yes.
The presumption is that you know part A, part B, those things. And also I'll tell you, always target at 450 to 500, at least minimum 450. Straight away get into the things. You can jot down any slide you want to come back. You can jot down and we'll get back to that. Okay. So strategies.
Okay, father.
When you get into part C of OET reading, these are the strategies that you have to use. Search for clues. First thing is to skim, you know. When you skim, you have to search for clues in the sense title, section headings, subheadings, so also names, maybe of the person or some device or body parts, whatever the names, and abbreviations, you know, what is abbreviation, short forms, and the number, six or three, you know, six will be spelled out. That is the rule. When you write single digits, you have to spell out, and double digits, you have to write in digits. So mostly if you search for single digit as number, you may not find it. So you'll have to read it. So 60 or other are double digits numbers you can find as numbers. Have a glance at those things. If they mention some percentage, those things also you should be noticing. And as I told you in my part A, normally all the English competitive exams just test all these aspects in your competency, like synonyms, comparisons, contrast, scale, narration, direct speech or passive voice, active voice, and the use of adjectives. Okay, so search for clues in the text. Scale, synonyms, or synonymous language. Synonyms are different than synonymous language, cause and effect language, comparison, contrast, types, those will be important, chronology or time expressions, also paraphrasing and model. These are the things you have to look in. And don't worry, I'm going to give you the paragraph, an official Part C reading paragraph text, and we'll find all these things over there. When I say search for clues, you should also be able to scale. I told you, scale. What is scale? Something like all is not most, mostly is not many, a few means some. So you should be able to identify the scale. If there is a scale expression around that, there is an answer. There's a clue that you can reach the answer. This also I explained to you in part A. If at all somebody needs an extra explanation, please let me know. In the Q&A session, others can leave and we'll explain. And anywhere you want to stop me, you can unmute and stop. And synonyms also, I told you. Synonyms as well as synonymous language. Those are the different things, you know. Saddam Hussein was killed. You cannot say the soldier was executed. You cannot say he was killed. He was murdered. You can't say Indira Gandhi was murdered or killed or executed. She was assassinated. And the sheep was slaughtered. So these all come from the word to kill. The meaning is same, but then these are the synonyms. They have their own meanings in different contexts. So you should be able to identify those things. And reading subtext, as you know, two long passages of healthcare. You are required to have a careful reading task. Around 800 words, need not be exactly 800. Maybe 35 minutes you can allot for it. Identify detailed meaning and opinion. 8-4 option. MCQs, 18 to 2 texts, you have 16 questions, time available, roughly 35 minutes. So we are getting straight away into the strategies. Know the instructions, that's the first thing. 2 texts about different aspects of healthcare. 4 questions, 7 to 22, choose the answer A, B, C, or D, which fits best according to the text. Fits best according to the test, there are 2 meanings for this. Highlight the fits best according to the test. One meaning is that it is not the right answer they are asking you. It should be the correct answer. Maybe there are more than one right answer in the options out of 4 options. But any competitive exam requires you to give them the not right answer, but correct answer.
May I know the difference, father? What is the right and what is the correct?
For example, a simple example I'll give you. This is a very silly example. Human beings have dashed legs. Okay, the first option is 1 plus 1. Second option is 3 minus 1. Third option is 4 minus 2. Fourth option is 2. Which is the correct answer? Which is the right answer?
2.
Yeah, 2 is the correct answer, but all other answers are right answers. Right.
Yeah.
Yes, so there will be some tricks where they play. You should be able to understand. For example, imagine that I have come to your place and you are in an institute where I'm going to train you. And one particular day, I tell Nishita, I'd like to have warm water for bathing. Okay? Nishita goes and tells the warden, father wants hot water for bathing. Is that right?
No, father. Hot water is different and warm water is different.
Hot water and warm water is different. The pad, you know, the hot pad you use in the medical system, mm-hmm. it's written by caution. Don't use boiled water. Drink hot water. Not boiled water. Boiled is not hot. Hot is not warm. Warm is not. So this is called as, you have to write exactly, warm water means warm, not hot. Those are the tricks they will play. That's why I said, text answer which fits best according to the text. According to the text means not according to your knowledge. You might know better than the text. But if it is not given in the text, please don't use that. Your knowledge into the text. Feed your knowledge into the text. And second one, advice to candidates, no thematic links between the two texts. There is no, for example, in the part A, you have thematic link between four texts. Here, you have separate, entirely separate two texts. Can the question for keywords. So, no thematic links. But then, there is a link or same theme in the same text. One text, first text, one text. Each text has a theme and it should be you should be able to focus on the sequence in the text. So, the QTA method, I have already explained to you in the previous sessions. Then go to the text, then only to the answer options. Never go to the answer options before you and skim it. And the best skill you should have is to skip. Caught up with one question, never ever stay there. Immediately skip into the next one. Number the paragraphs without wasting time. You should know the nature of the text, what type of text it is. Identify the paragraph, the structure, and the last one, somebody could read, focus of the text. Those things, if need be, I'll come back. Those are already explained. So third strategy is to know the format. Questions appear in the order of the information in the text. It means you never need to go back for to the previous para for the next answer. Always in a progressive order. So I said skipping is the best skill. For example, you haven't got answer for fourth question. You skip and go. You got third and you got fifth. When you visit back, you know the fourth answer is between third and fifth. So it's very easy to locate instead of reading widely and wasting your time. Okay, fourth skill is skim the text. Skimming means you have to just understand the organization structure or sequence of the text. Quickly look through the text to understand how the text is organized, what is it about, what is the focus of the text, and what is the gist of the text. Identify the main idea or topic of each paragraph. Look into the details, but only the main idea of each paragraph. Understanding general sense of the text. Fifth one is five different question types. This is the most important part. You should be very sure about these things. Then only you'll be able to understand what they are asking for. There are five different types, question types in part C of OET reading. First one is asking about the detail. Here they will test you whether you can scan and get into the detail. Hope you know the difference between skimming and scanning. Skimming is simply to just get into the main idea, go through the headings, subheadings, titles, numbers, names, all those things I told you. Whereas scanning is to read again and again to find out the details or ultimate meaning. But then all questions will not be in that sense. You have one question in one text maybe about the detail. No. Someone will be about the attitude. You'll be asked to identify the attitude of the office writing the text. And third one will be opinion. You must be able to identify the opinion. Many things being said in the text. Maybe the author may quote many people, many research works, many studies. But you should be able to identify between the studies being represented and the author's opinion. Now, it will be used to, model verb will be usually used for expressing opinion. So you should be able to identify those model verbs. And vocabulary. There will be definitely a question on vocabulary. Just that will be highlighted and underlined in the text. Easy to find out where it is. Even in the question, it will be question statement, it will be highlighted and underlined. It will be bold. Find the meaning in the context. Vocabulary means lexical question. And the fifth one is reference questions. Reference means first you use a name, then you use pronoun or a reference word. For example, you say all the students are interested in OET examination and they work hard. So they is the reference for all the students. So just to know whether you can understand the reference. Or Deepthi is intelligent, but she is a bit lazy. She's a bit lazy. So she represents Deepthi. As simple as that. So these two questions, in both the paragraphs, you have two questions which are very easy. Usually you can, without reading, you can even give the answer. Is that clear to you? Part C has these five types of questions. One is asking you to assessing you whether you can understand the detail from the reading. Second one is to whether you understand the attitude of the author. Third one, whether you understand the opinion of the author. Fourth one is your vocabulary. What is the strength of your vocabulary? And fifth one is the reference. Opinion of the writer. Detail, attitude. And the focus on the views and opinion of the writer. These three aspects, detail, attitude and opinion, will be focusing on the views and opinions of the writer. And the vocabulary, a single word or phrase underlined in bold in the question and the text. Decide what the word or phrase relates to. A single word or phrase underlined, bold in the question and the text. To be able to decide what is the word, what is the meaning in the context. Complex sentences. Usually references will be given in the complex sentences. So you should know the structure of the complex sentence. This is the text we are going to take. I'll give you a bit of time to read. Could you just read by yourself? If you're done, please tell me yes. And get the gist of the paragraph, just write down on your paper. Read in detail, just skim through. A general reading. Now, if you remember in the first part A, I told you there is a focus or sequence in every text. And that was between four texts, definition, clinical assessment, I told you, management, monitoring. This sequence I have shown you. So here you have a sequence. Each paragraph has a theme. The first paragraph speaks about significance of voice and effects of voice loss. And the second paragraph speaks about synthetic voice, speech replacement device. Synthetic voice means artificial speech replacement device. And the third paragraph speaks about genesis and advancement of electrical communication, beginning and advancement of electrical communication. The fourth paragraph speaks about sophistication of digital voice banks and sophistication of these hearing aids or instruments. And the fifth paragraph speaks about voice donation as another stage of development. And sixth paragraph speaks about software made available to each and every patient. This sequence should be understood when you read. As I told you, there is a topic sentence in every paragraph. And there are supporting sentences. You remember the example I gave you if you have attended my session? Mahatma Gandhiji is the father of our nation. What is the key word here?
Father.
That paragraph will speak only about the paternal qualities of Mahatma Gandhiji, nothing else. You cannot speak about where Mahatma Gandhiji was born or where did he study, all those things. They cannot speak in that. Paragraph has to speak only why we call him as the father of the nation. Next, the supporting sentence or sentences will explain why we call him or respect him as the father of the nation. Then give some examples of Dandi Satyagraha or whatever you want to. And then continue saying that hence Indians proudly consider him as the father of the nation. So there is a focus in every paragraph. That focus and sequence between the paragraphs, if you understand, when you skim, you normally, most of the cases, 95% of the cases, the first sentence will be the topic sentence. Rarely there are exceptions. I have taken an exception today as well. Where will I show you? But normally it is the first sentence. So if you understand the first sentence of every paragraph, you understand the whole text. So in order for you to summarize a book of 2,000 pages, maybe like a advanced learner's dictionary, you don't require more than 2 or 3 hours. So you need not go into the detail to summarize a book. The topic sentence, if you just glance at the topic sentence, it will give you the sequence and the summary and the main idea of the paragraph. So the strategies are this: a search for clues, name, abbreviation. Once again, I'm bringing to your notice these things because we are launching into the analysis of the paragraph, whereby you will understand all these things. So when you skim in the first instance, as you go through the text, try to find out the names. As I told you, it can be of some researchers, some doctors, some specialists, or some human beings, or some device, or some body parts, whatever. Then look at the abbreviations. The answers will be around these things. And understand the scale, synonyms, and synonymous language. Paraphrasing, comparison, the complex sentence, the sentence structure, trust and types or distinctions or classifications, chronology, time expressions, first, second, all those things, ancient or modern, those things. Paraphrasing. Paraphrasing means your question statement will be using other words. So in different words. So paraphrasing has to be understood. And the model words. These are the major things you have to look for in the paragraph. It doesn't mean all these things will be found in every paragraph, but one of these things will be definitely found, and usually 2 or 3 things will tell you here is the answer. Then last one is adjectives and passive. Hope you know the base. Now the author's view question. We have taken an official paragraph, maybe from the platform where you are discussing with some challenges in the paragraph. I have taken the same text for your analysis. And this is a question I would like somebody to read for me.
In the first paragraph, the writer suggests loss of voice is difficult for patients because it is.
What are the keywords?
Writer suggests loss of voice because.
They are asking for it?
A reason.
Reason.
And they are asking for suggestion of the writer. There will be many other suggestions. But they are asking, what does the writer suggest? Maybe writer will say, many of the researchers suggested this, or they declared this as the thing. But then author has his own, writer has his own suggestion. So you have to concentrate on that. So suggest is difficult for patients because it is, these are the options. And you see, very beginning of the text begins with many reasons why. Okay. And you have the main thing is loss of voice. Writer suggests loss of voice is difficult for patients because it is, you lose the voice, it is difficult for you. You read like this. I've read the paragraph. We'll not be reading it in detail now. Let us read just the question, not the text. Just read with me. In the first paragraph, the writer suggests loss of voice is difficult for patients because it is part of their identity. Voice is difficult for patients, or they don't want to have it because it is necessary for interaction. Voice necessary for interaction. If you are dumb, can you interact better? The third one I am reading, loss of voice is difficult for patients because you used to form relationships. And loss of voice form relationships with better relationships? No.
No further. No,
because
no,
voice is must, because you should be able to speak, communicate. And the fourth one, loss of voice is difficult for patients because it is an indicator of social class. If you are dumb, if you lose your voice, you'll be a higher class in the society. You'll be respected.
No further.
No further.
So all these things without reading the text itself clearly says B, C, D cannot be the option at all because it is just contradicting. It's just saying what is good as bad. So something negative, the B, C, D says it is good. So definitely even without going into the question, you can understand. You have to read that way. You should not read just the options. You have to read if there is a because it is, you have to start from there. Loss of voice is difficult for patients because it is part of their identity. Now you have an idea, this should be the answer. And you go into that loss of voice, where you have the loss of voice, speaks about loss of voice along, and it says it is an integral part of who we are. Integral part of who we are means what? Our identity, right?
Yes, sir.
Our voices define us. Define us means our identity, again. Second time it is stressing. Our voices allow our loved ones to identify us. Again, our identity because of our voice. So three times it stresses and says, this is the correct answer. Actually, you don't require to go into the paragraph. If you want to go, you can definitely confirm, reconfirm. Again, you confirm as you come back if you have an extra time. Here, there is nothing to confirm. Evident from the options itself is the answer. Whole concept, focus of the paragraph is loss of voice. Then you have tremendously be difficult for the patient to deal with both practically and emotionally. Tremendously difficult. Is that clear? So we'll get into the real analysis. It is tremendously difficult. In reasons, because reasons is given in the topic sentence. Okay. Part of their identity. Second one again, part of, integral part of who we are, part of their identity. Third one again, our voices define us. See, an integral part of who we are, our voices define us, allow our loved ones to identify us. These are the synonymous language. So loss of voice is difficult for patients. That is paraphrased as, it is tremendously difficult for the patient. This is called paraphrasing. Loss of voice is tremendously difficult. Here it is difficult for patients. There is a slight difference in the structure, syntax of the sentence, but it means same. Clear?
Yes, Father.
So we go to the second question. Could somebody read?
Why does the writer believe it is important that a speech replacement devices can be operated by a variety of methods?
Writer believe. What does it tell you?
Writer believe.
His opinion. Writer's opinion. I believe that you are all good students, good learners. Mm-hmm. My opinion, no?
Yes, Father.
Yeah. So this is an opinion question. Why tells you? They are asking for a reason. It is important that speech replacement devices be operated by a variety of methods. So the focus is speech replacement devices. The operation of speech replacement devices. Have a glance at the text. See, this is the topic sentence, what I told you. The most synthetic voices are the most common type of speech replacement device. Those who have permanently lost their voice. So it's important. Patients, other disabilities account. Take the patient's other disabilities into it. I've read here, you know, why does the writer believe it is important that speech replacement devices be operated by a variety of methods? Admitted that you have read the paragraph. That's why we are not reading. Otherwise, you read the question, then go to the text, then come to the options. Speech replacement devices be operated by a variety of methods. The technology should be kept up to date. Does it speak about speech replacement?
No.
This is speaking about a device. This is speaking about the technology. Okay, no? And healthcare workers might also need to use.
No.
Healthcare workers are not speech replacement devices, right? The question speaks about speech replacement device, not about the healthcare workers, what they should do, what are their obligations. No notice here. Devices should be usable across a range of platforms. We're speaking about range devices should be used. The devices, which are the devices, should be usable, even if it is speech replacement devices, usable across a range of platforms. But here they are saying by operate by a variety of methods. Methods are different from platforms, right?
Yeah.
In each platform, there will be a method.
Mm-hmm.
Correct?
Yeah.
So this is how you have to understand the question.
Okay.
So almost, you know, these things are not connected to this. So here they are asking for method, here they are speaking about platform. Patients often suffer from various conditions. See, this is called paraphrasing, synonymous language being used. See, it is important that speech replacement devices for those who have lost their voice take the patient's other disabilities into account. Means, operated by various methods, here they are saying, patient's other disabilities should be taken into account. Various conditions means other disabilities, right? You say as a sickness, as a condition, right? A syndrome, a condition. So, here various conditions, here other disabilities.
Other disabilities.
And patients often suffer from, patient's other disabilities should be taken into account. Patients account. Often suffer from various conditions. Let us look into the strategies. Let's look at the strategies. Mm-hmm. Scale is used here. Classification used here, type, and patients often suffer from, and it is important. It is important. This is the keyword we highlighted here. It is important means, again, a scale. Like, it is most important, it is important, it is less significant, less important. So, say a scale expression tells you the answer is around here. And speech placement revises, that is the focus of the paragraph. That's why I said, this is the topic sentence, what I highlighted and underlined. This is a topic sentence. So when you read, you should be able to identify the controlling idea of the topic sentence. This is known as the topic sentence, and this is known as the controlling idea in the topic sentence. Means speech replacement device. That is the concept. As I said, Mahandiji is the father. Paternal qualities in that paragraph. So this will speak only about speech replacement device. This is the concept. Here again, you have that keyword in the question. So synonymous language being used, patients' other disabilities should be taken into account. Okay.
Yeah.
Condition means synonymous. Yeah. Condition means what you have in the text, disabilities.
Disability.
Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
You don't get confused. Take patience. You go cool. If you have any doubt, you can ask me. I'll clarify those things.
All right, sir.
In the third paragraph, we learned that Reg Malling developed a POSM due to.
And Reg Malling, there is a name.
Name.
You see? Name. POSM, there is a. Abbreviation.
Abbreviation.
So immediately you can get into the location. No? Let's see. CPOSM is here. Reg Malling is here.
Developed by.
Reg Malling is here. POSM here. And developed by. Developed by. Reg Malling developed. This is what I called it passive voice. Active voice and passive voice will be used. Here they are using passive voice. Here in the question statement they have active voice. Here you have passive voice. That's a trick they play. So you should be able to understand it was developed by Reg Malling means Reg Malling developed, right?
Yeah.
That's the only difference they play. So this was, I said, the strategy you should know. Immediately you have the name here, you have the abbreviation here. So it should be here. Answer should be, POSM due to the number of people who had permanently lost their voice, the lack of accessibility in previous SIP and PUF designs, the limited communication options for disabled people, the recent development of similar sound technology. Here, reading into this thing, you will not be able to identify. But then they have helped you with two things. One name and one abbreviation to locate the answer. So immediately, you have to go to that abbreviation and read from there. POSM was developed by Reg Malling, the voluntary hospital for paralyzed people. After he discovered that patients at the hospital who had lost the use of their voice were only able to communicate using a pen. Only means limited. Synonymous language is
limited.
Able to communicate using a bell. The limited communication options for disabled people. Only option they have is to communicate using a bell. Ring the bell. The limited communication options for disabled patients. And he doesn't mention anything about the number of people who had permanently lost their voice. No? You see, Reg Malling developed the POSM due to the number of people who had permanently lost their voice. He doesn't speak anything of that. Throughout the rest of the 20th century, these technologies were gradually developed, and he is giving illustrations, examples for this. So I told you the topic sentence, then the explanation, developing sentence, and then you have the supporting sentences, then you have the developing sentence. Developing sentence means illustrations and examples.
Yes, further.
It's also said appeal method. First, you have to state your point, or when you read, the first sentence will be the point, main point, idea of your paragraph. Then second point will be explanation. Second and third sentences or few sentences will be explanation about the topic sentence, the controlling idea. Then you have developing sentence or developing sentences means examples and illustrations. then peel, P-E-E-L, lay means link. You link it to the topic sentence at the end. So if you know that structure, you know easily where to find the answer. This is how we have to practice. Don't practice so many texts, but try to understand this way and try to make a PPT and send it to me. I'll tell you whether it is correct. Spend some time. That will give you a clear picture in your mind. Try to underline, sketch out the important text, abbreviation, and you have the scale here only. This is a scale expression. Was developed by the main verb in the main expression here, pragmatic develop. So it is here. And then you have limited is only. And you have able to communicate using a bell. Communication options for disabled. So you have these systems show a remarkable advancement from one of the earliest speech to text mechanisms designed in the 60s.
You have a name,
or abbreviation, just search in that sentence and see the paraphrasing. And before you get into the text, try to understand what is paraphrasing. Try to work out some paraphrasing, or even from the readings, whatever the paraphrasing and passive voice, active voice used, just write down those sentences in a notebook. And that will help you a lot in improving your reading skill. According to the writer, why were early portable AACs problematic for those not in wheelchairs? According to the writer, means again our writer's opinion, right?
Opinion.
Yeah. So you should be very careful. If there is some other opinion given there, you should be able to distinguish from that. Why were early portable AACs problematic? The focus is problematic portable AACs. Okay. Why were the early cell phones were problematic? Because that was huge, right? You remember when the cell phones came in first? If you remember, that was a huge one. It's something like that. Why was the early mobile phones problematic? So you have to say, what was the problem with the AACs? All those things. We'll go to the text, then we'll come back to the options. So same text, okay? Previous text. What you have seen? The same text, but at the second part, you have this answer. See, again here, say numbers, I told you, no? You should be very cautious about the numbers. When you skim, you have to identify the numbers. If you have identified the number, you know the answer is there. See numbers here, 15 to 20 pounds, 50 to 20 to 25 inches. So numbers means measurements or whatever. Okay? So portable. Portable is here. The keyword, no? Once you underline the key expression here in the question statement, you have to find the key expression in the text. So, or they are synonyms. They were advertised as portable. These devices, although, this is called complex sentence. Although they were advised as portable, there is a contrast here. Although they were advised as portable, these devices often weighed a hefty 50 to 20 pounds and tended to range from 20 to 25 inches in size. Is that clear? What does it mean? Yeah. They were heavy and bulky.
Yeah.
Let's analyze. Okay. Number and measurement given here. I told you, when you skim, you should be able to focus on these things. See, contrast portable and heavy. Portable but heavy. You say mobile phone, but you cannot carry it. You need a truck for that. There is contrast, no? Portable means it should be easy to carry, right? But then it is heavy, though. So there is a contrast. There is a number and measurement. How many strategies you see telling it is the answer? Answer is here. Come and touch me. Complex sentence again. Whenever there is a complex sentence, there is a possibility of an answer there. Yeah, how strategies, once you know the strategies, how clearly the answer can be located. And I tell you, you can definitely, out of 35 minutes, you can save 10 minutes and enjoy sitting and enjoy, sit and look around and enjoy what others are struggling with. Okay? Portable, contrast is heavy and bulky. See, synonym, bulky means? Heavy. Bulky means size. Bulky in size, right? So beautifully it is given. These are called synonyms. So you have to write down these expressions. It doesn't mean same thing will have come for the exam, but definitely you will get that mind mental setup to look into the synonyms. That is lexical question. Very beautiful one. The writer uses the phrase raising the bar to underline what? So raising the bar is highlighted and bold and underlined, even in the text. This will be highlighted and underlined. Okay, so you need not go into very far. You can just read that. Proponents of new digital voice banks are working toward raising the bar by steadily widening the scope for self-expression among the many millions of diverse users of AACs. The United States, there are now over 2 million people who rely on such devices in their day-to-day communications, yet many users still have to make do with a limited number of vocal devices, often less than a dozen, with the majority of available voices sounding adult and or male. This is extremely problematic, as users need to choose a voice that they feel represents who they are. So this paragraph speaks about limitations, ACs, because female voices are not available. Kids' voices are not available. So the proponents of new digital voice banks are working toward raising the bar. Means what? Raising the bar means improving the system. Improving the
system. Or
yeah,
standard.
So it cannot underline the complexity of modern devices because it is positive. Complexity is negative, no? Raising the bar is positive. A need for a diverse range of voices. Raising the bar cannot speak about a need. It's not a verb, but it's an expression. It's an action. High quality of the sound recordings. No. Number of new communication systems. Big sentence, as we said, lexical question. See, new is the adjective. I told you, adjective is one of the strategies. Usually, the adjective, use of adjectives will highlight there is an answer. And raising the bar will be highlighted and underlined. So, you need not research anywhere. Bold and underline. And new adjective is here. New. Whereas here, you don't have that adjective at all in these three. That's why I said strategies will guide you and give you a clear idea. Voice banks means communication system. Here they say voice banks. Here they are saying communication system. So that is called?
So it's clear, Father.
Now, I think this is again lexical question. You can answer even without going. What is suggested about voice donation by the phrase, go the extra mile? You know, usually you have to, if you have to get a grade in OET, you have to go the extra mile. Means?
Do little more work.
Yeah,
like
do
extra
little
work.
Extra work. To do little, put some little effort, extra effort. So what does it, what does it suggest? Donation centers are often far away. It doesn't mean, no? Far away is not something that you are going to do. Right?
Yeah.
A large number of voices are rejected. Doing extra mile is not rejection, not negative, no?
Yes,
Father. Yeah.
Sacrifice more than organ donators. Donators sacrifice more than organ donators. Extremely time consuming. Now, there is a little confusion between these two. So, go to the text. Actually, you have to go to the text first. Since you read it, to save the time, I am going this way. Okay? As soon as you read the text, question statement, you have to go to the text. See, here you have the topic sentence. The second sentence. First sentence is not the topic sentence, it's a connective sentence. Another alternative open to patients is to make use of the increasing number of voices being donated. So the whole paragraph speaks about voice donation. Although voice donation does not require the contributor to physically give a part of themselves away, as is the case with the classical medical donations, like kidney donation or eye donation, you need not give something physically, you need not donate something. Donors certainly must go the extra mile. Which donors? Voice donators. What is the extra mile? The process of voice donation is much more extensive than, say, the comparison expression, donating a kidney or the other physical organ. While the donation is an organ, donation of an organ requires a relatively short stay in hospital, to donate a voice requires many weeks of donor commitment. This is the extra mile. We have to stay many weeks in the hospital. So you see short stay and stay for many weeks. Mm. The contrast, no? And the comparison you have a complex sentence here starting while. So all this tells you answer is here.
Yeah, many weeks. Yeah.
Go extra mile. The process is extremely time consuming, you see? Mm. Time consuming. This speaks about time, nothing else. You need not give a body part, but then you have to give a lot of time in the hospital for a longer period. Let's go into the analysis. Topic sentence here. Once you understand the topic sentence, easily you get to the answer. Contrast, you see, short stay and weeks. And scale, you see, many. Scale is being used. And complex sentence is being used. All these indicate there is an answer here. Okay? Comparison being used. These are the things I told you should be able to identify. When you have an issue, when you don't find the answer easily, you can look into all these things. Bold and underlined usually in the text, as well as lexical question, as well as reference questions, both look almost similar. Speaks about your vocabulary, how far you can understand the word. So, synonyms use that, extremely time consuming. extremely time consuming here in the question option, answer option, much more extensive here. Synonymous language requires many weeks, means time consuming. Synonymous language is being used. This paragraph, the word user refers to, here you do not need the whole thing, you can just go to the user if you want, refers to whom? Healthcare workers, patients, AC technology developers. So user refers to whom? Refers to whom? Means a group of people, right? Or somebody. So the speak, and I told you this speaks about voice donation and voice donors. Topic sentence speaks about voice donation, and it can speak only about voice donation and voice donors, donators or donors. So here there are categories: healthcare workers, patients, and ASA technology developers. One of them is voice donators. From this basic controlling idea, what is the answer? You know, controlling idea of the topic sentence is voice donation, right?
Yeah.
It cannot be healthcare workers, it cannot be patients, it cannot be technology developers. It should be voice donors or voice donation connected. So donors must speak many thousands of pre-selected words, phrases and sentences into a recording microphone. Some companies offer a service tailored to the user. Who is the user here? Donor.
Means
he is recording, he is reading, who can read science fiction or fantasy stories out loud? You know, he is reading, he has to speak out continuously or read a book continuously for weeks together, where they will record it, and that will be considered a synthetic voice. They convert it into synthetic voice. So here the user is, user of the company is donors.
Donor. Father.
By donors.
Father. Yeah. Is father, user is usually who use the device, right? But how it can indicate the voice donator, father?
That's what I'm telling you. You should know, does this paragraph topic sentence speaks about the users or voice donation and voice donators? Is there anywhere one expression where it speaks about the patients, the whole paragraph?
Talking about the donors.
No, father.
Yeah. That's why I said this is a linking word to the previous sentence. This is the exceptionally you have second sentence of the topic sentence. So I'm telling another alternative open to patients is to make use of the increase in number of voices being donated. So the thing is speaking about donors, and here you see donors must speak many thousands of pre-selected words, phrases, and sentences into a recording microphone. Some companies offer a service tailored to the user. So usually, referent comes just after the noun. For example, Soumya is continuously into practicing the OET text every day. And some of the institutes are giving her professional materials. So her means it should be Soumya, no?
Yes,
noun will be the referent. It will be referring to the previous noun, not before that. Now, which is the previous noun? Immediately is donors. Okay? Here the similar word is used, donators. Voice, donators or donors?
Yes, father. No. If mobile users is the person who is using the mobile, right, father?
Yeah.
Not the company who invented the mobile. The same way here, user refers to. So, the person who is using the voice, I mean synthetic voices, or the person who is donating the voice, father. That's my concern, actually.
I'm just reading it for you. Listen to me or father. Look at the screen.
Father.
See, understand from here. The process of voice donation is much more extensive than, say, donating a kidney or other physical organ while all these things can be just excluded. Say whatever you say after that. Just read like this. The process of voice donation is much more extensive. While the donation of an organ requires a relatively short stay in hospital, to donate your voice requires many weeks of donor commitment. Many weeks of donor commitment. What is it speaking about, this sentence? Donors or
recording time consuming.
Speaking about the
donors. So that's what I said. The previous sentence speaks about donors, and they have to spend a lot of time in the
It's me, Father Krishna.
Okay.
Yes, Father.
Okay, Krishna. Did you get it?
Yes, father.
Yeah.
Father.
From when you speak from here, these sentences, both the previous two sentences has nothing to do. Maybe could you tell me what was your idea? What could it refer to?
I thought it might be the patients with permanent loss of voice, father. Because from the word, like topic sentence, another alternative open to patients to make. So from there, I got the word patients. And the, of course, the whole topic is talking about the voice loss. So I thought the answer will be B, father.
Okay. Now the problem is, that's why I highlighted here, in a topic sentence, there's a controlling idea.
Mm-hmm.
For example, small class cars are economical. That is not a topic sentence.
Mm-hmm.
Small cars are economical as regards maintenance. Maintenance is the controlling idea of that paragraph.
Mm-hmm.
So you'll be that paragraph will be speaking only about maintenance, not about other things of the small car. There will be various aspects. So also, this is the controlling idea in the topic sentence. Now the alternative open to patients is to make use of the increase in number of voices being donated. Another option that in Abu Dhabi is to make use of the public transport service. Now you are giving a lecture to the newcomers who are coming to Gulf. If you don't have a vehicle, another option for you is to either one option you can say you can share a vehicle with your friend. Okay. Or another option is to use the public transport. Now, next sentences, should you speak about public transport or about your friend? Are you getting my idea? I'm speaking to everybody. Okay.
Yes, father. Yes, father.
I'm speaking about, maybe you are about the culture, about the living conditions in Gulf area. You are explaining to someone from India. So first, you speak about transport. Under transport, you have two paragraphs. One paragraph speaks about owning your own car. Another paragraph speaks about sharing with your friend a car. Third one could speak about another alternative open to the nurses is to make use of the public transport. What is the controlling idea?
Public transport.
Public transport. Then whatever is referred is to the public transport, right?
Yes, father.
Though nurses are and transport, everything is important there, but it is speaking about the public transport alone, not the transport in general. Is that clear?
Yes, father.
Yeah. Then your voices being donated means voice donation and voice donators. These are the aspects being discussed here. That is the controlling idea. You can't speak about anything else, about patient's condition or patient's difficulties, problems. Those things were discussed in the previous paragraphs. Here, the controlling idea is voices being donated, means voice donation, means you have to say who donates it, how they donate, what are the procedure of donation. Correct? No, if you are speaking about blood donation.
Yes, father, that point is fine, father. But in the next lines, like donor must speak many thousands of pre-selected words, phrases and sentences into a recording microphone. After that, they are giving some companies offer a service tailored to the user. So user is obviously the patient because we are using these synthetic voices for for the patient.
Do you have any reference to the patient here?
If we thought in the reference way, it is donor to user. Okay, father. But sentence, if we read.
Yeah.
Still, I'm not at all convinced, father. Sorry.
It's fine. It is like here the problem in this paragraph is voice donation is the issue.
Mm-hmm.
There are people who are willing to donate their voice, which is very, very essential to create these synthetic voice instruments, no? AACs. Now the problem is they have to come and stay in the hospital for weeks together and continuously speak or read out books into the microphone, the recording.
Mm. Yes, father. Okay.
So the problem is for them. They have to must speak many thousands of pre-selected words, phrases, and sentences into a recording microphone.
Ooh.
Some companies offer a service tailored to the user. Who is the user now?
Patient.
Oh my goodness.
No, donor. Donor is the user.
The patient at all. Patient doesn't come anywhere in this.
No.
Patient doesn't appear in this paragraph at all. The controlling idea is voice donation. Yeah. They are not speaking about who that will be. This is the blood bank. Blood will be taken to different places.
Mm.
That even transportation is not thought of here. Only recording the voices from the donors is the issue here. Imagine you are a center where you record the voice. You are in charge of that institution, okay? Do you think about the patients there? You think about the donors who are coming, how to make them comfortable, how to make them easy, how to make them feeling good here, and how to record maximum this one. That's how you get money. Okay, commission or whatever. Are you getting my point?
Yes, Father.
So that's why I said this is a reading skill. Now I am teaching you maybe the college syllabus without teaching the high school syllabus. High school syllabus is to understand the structure of a paragraph, structure of an article. Okay,
Father. Thank you, Father.
If there is an article, for example, introduction, will have a general statement. Then you will have a thesis statement. Okay. Then one paragraph, first body paragraph, the topic sentence, developing sentence, supporting sentences, developing sentences. Then the connecting word or the link or the paraphrasing of the topic sentence. Then you have the second paragraph. There is a topic sentence. Then developing sentence, supporting sentences, which explains the topic sentence. Then developing sentences, which are the examples and illustrations. Then you have the conclusion in that paragraph, which is the paraphrasing of the topic sentence itself. So every paragraph has got a structure, and every topic sentence has got a controlling idea. And that paragraph will speak only about, that's what when I told you about the topic sentence, I said Mahatma Gandhiji is the father of our nation, father is the TA word, and that paragraph will speak only about paternal qualities. If any referent is used, that is referring only to the father, mother Mahatma Gandhiji, not to anybody else, not to anything else. So here, the issue is voice donation. Voice is being donated. And here, you speak only about the donors and the procedure and the voice. Nothing else. Okay?
Okay, Father.
So you have to think in that line. And this is the most challenging thing I have taken, because some people and our students had asked me doubts about this. That's why I thought, let me take the same text. Otherwise, you may not have that difficult. But then, once you have that skill, it is very evident here. You don't even think of patients, because patient is not in this paragraph at all. This is not an hospital at all, I tell you. You being a committed nurse, you are concerned about patients, but this paragraph is nothing to do with hospitals at all. Okay.
Okay, Father. Thank you.
So don't think of your patients here. And I tell you, I can send you if you don't have. I think you must have this. No? It was in the
program. Yeah, I have, Father.
Try to read it, or another best method, I tell you, if you are a Malayali or Kannada, whatever your mother tongue, if you find a paragraph so challenging, try to translate into your mother. Try to translate that into your mother tongue. The best method is that. Then you will have revelations.
We'll follow, Father. Thank you.
The connections you will see. You just try, Krishna, you try this paragraph. You try it. Thank you. Today itself, you try to translate the whole paragraph into Malayalam. You are a Malayali, right?
No, Father. I'm from Andhra, Telugu.
Oh, okay. Telugu. You translate into Telugu. So I can't connect. Okay. Otherwise, I thought you can send it to me. Telugu, I'm not. Okay. Good.
Thank you, Father, for being so, patient to clearing my doubts. Thank you.
Okay, that's done with. I think the analysis part we have not done. Okay. I'll just show you here. Donors, donators. Topic sentence, voices being donated is the keyword, this one, controlling idea. Synonymous language being used, voice being donated, voice donators, voice being donated. This is the way they usually ask. The other one was the maximum challenging one which I took. Here is a reference. What does the word it refers to in the final paragraph? Once your voice has been comprehensively recorded, it then becomes part of the software for AACs. What does it mean
to voice?
Reference. Voice, not just voice. Voice has been
synthetic recorded. Voice.
Means recorded voice. Means synthetic voice.
Synthetic voice.
Once your voice has been comprehensively recorded, means voice being recorded, right? Recorded voice, which means synthetic voice. See, a presentation given by a professor. Nothing to do here. See, referent is just after the concept that what it is referring to. As I said, Krishna is brilliant. He has to pop up with the 12-hour duty. So the she refers to not to brilliance, but to Krishna. Once a voice has been comprehensively recorded, a presentation given by the professor, the research carried out for the professor, nothing here about research and professor, the permanent loss of voice of the professor, nothing to do with and made available to any patient that needs it. Again, it is there. So what does it mean? Synthetic voice. So the synthetic voice used by the professor, it is synthetic voice. Once a voice has been comprehensively recorded, it then becomes part of the software. Recorded voice becomes. Recorded voice synonym here is synthetic voice. So I said the synonymous expressions, paraphrasing, most important here. And also model verbs. So again, it emphasizes here if you have any doubt. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
So this will be the reference questions. You see how many reference questions, how many lexical questions, how easy it is, how interesting it is. Passive voice, see the synthetic voice used by the professor. So this is not a marketing platform at all. I will never ever take you for a payment for any course. So this is not a marketing platform. Marketing platform, people just want to pull you into that session and get more and more people. And always I tell you, my best suggestion for you is this. Cool down. Don't hurry up. So enjoy the studies, fall in love with the studies, the analysis of the paragraph, and definitely you can get into a grade. There is no issue at all in reading practice. Maximum you need to practice 12 to 15 reading texts, but analyze it every bit of it. As I said, if you don't understand something, you can ask me. And even for writing, many of you are sending me the written letters, but you know, it's not that easy to correct hundreds of letters. And especially when you are not writing in a format or anything. So I'll be taking one more session. And normally I tell you, at least do work with the 10 case notes before starting your writing your first letter. Try to highlight, as I told you, under the ISBAR strategy. Try to highlight the top, main points and exclude the unnecessary details. And analyze and study the case notes. That is the best part. At least 10 of them before you begin the first letter. Then only start writing letters. Okay. So, and if you are writing the letters, what I post in the platform, please do on that. So that what I have, same connection I can give to you all in a session. Maybe if there are 45 letters with me, same letter if you write, correction will go to everybody. I can take the same letter and explain it in a session in an hour. Otherwise, 45 letters, I'll need 45 hours, which is impossible. Impossible.
Yeah.
Okay. So, Try to be consistent, be cool, love the process, don't get frustrated, don't get frustrated with a lot of practice. It's not how many practices you did, how quality the practice is.
Further, can I get another, listening, reading and speaking sections, whether you will provide classes?
Yeah, immediately we'll have, within a few days, 2-3 days, we'll have listening.
Okay.
That, when the list is running, please sign it. Please, I try to sign that. Add your name.
Okay.
There is no other way. See, this is not a commercial platform. No, there is no other way. And let me know in your feedback what you require. So I know from various people when it is required. I can even today, as I did today, I started with some 9 names in the beginning. Because if I get from the feedback, I can add your name, telling that you are asked for listening session. So in the list, in the beginning itself, I will be adding those 10-15 names. And who else is interested in asking? If everybody gives me the feedback and out of now about 62 people you attended, 50 of you asked for listening, I'll be definitely putting those 50 names and saying if somebody else wants to join, please add your name. Understood, no?
Okay, Father. Thank you.
Welcome. We should do some homework like before practicing this original OET material. Should we do some reading, extra reading? Like
definitely. Actually, this process presupposes you have reading skill. They are testing your reading skill. So I don't suggest you have to go through all these reading materials, but better you have the, for example, British Medical Journal is the best thing. And most of the texts are taken from that, British Medical Journal. You can access it online. Or you read any medical journals, it's good because you get a lot of vocabs and also you understand the context, you get a lot of knowledge. If you are not immediately taking a date, always start reading medical journals. That's the best part of it.
Okay.
And don't do too many practice tests. That will give you saturation and frustration.
Yeah. Okay, Father, thank you.
Maybe, maybe. So what you need to, you need to develop. I tell you, you don't go into dictionaries or find out vocabs, but you try to write down whatever you come across. The vocabs, the synonyms language, paraphrasing, all those expressions, strategies from the text. That will give you an idea. And I suggest even to make some PPTs, if you are good at making PPTs, make some PPTs and learn. That will give you a visual effect to your learning. See?
Okay.
Now don't just sit children and read again and again and find it. Okay. So there is no challenging text or not challenging text, provided you have to improve the quality, competency of your language. That will happen. It will take at least 3 months. But my my problem here is that everybody starts practicing OET after booking the date for exam. Then that exam tension is in the mind. You cannot do anything. So always I suggest, world is not going to end. It has given you a long life. Even if you delay for 3 months or 6 months, fine. Enjoy the studies. Enjoy this experience. What's happening? Those who are hurrying up, they will write once, write twice, write thrice. Instead of 3 months or 6 months, they will do 2, 3 years and 4 years. That's the difference. Only difference from my experience, I tell you. But in the beginning itself, they are ready to take the patience. Okay, 6 months, I'm going to practice every day. Practice little, but consistently. That is the biggest secret of your success. Practice little, but consistently every day. Fix a time and practice. Don't practice so many, 5, 6. I could see some conversations, chats in the platform. Like every day, how many, 5 or 6, how many readings we have to practice. I tell you, part A is enough for a day. Take it, do it, analyze, understand, go back again and find whether you there is something which you did not understand. Then proceed. Maybe that's enough for that day. Part B is enough for a day. Understand well and write down the vocabs and in the context, some sentences, everything. Maybe in the previous session, I told you how to develop your vocabulary. Like, you know, I showed you on the slides. So you have to take the words and the sentences. Not just words, in the context. That's where I gave the example, round, R-O-U-N-D. The word round in English, R-O-U-N-D, has 76 meanings, different meanings. Only the context tells you what is the meaning of your word. Am I clear?
Yes. Thank you. Can you take that writing class one more time? Because we couldn't attend the class.
Definitely. It's going to be very hectic. It's going to be very hectic for me. Yes, sorry.
One more concern. Can you take a class regarding the listening strategies?
Yeah, next session will be on listening. How many things are there? That's what I told you, no? When you give me the feedback, mention it over there. That's what I said. If 20 of you mentioned listening, we require. Looking at that, I know most people require this. Immediately, I will organize a session for that. There are more than 400 and odd people in the platform.
Yeah.
And so that's why always I ask you to interact in the platform. You know? And if you, well, now I have made one platform. Usually I don't encourage WhatsApp groups because it's very difficult to even post the materials, videos, and other things. Not only that, it takes only 256 people. For 400 people, you'll have to carry on 3 WhatsApp groups. So Telegram is the best way. But then from Gulf, many were asking me, telling me that Wi-Fi, or I don't understand. I'm not familiar with the Gulf region. They have some issues with the network if you have to enter into a Telegram. So today I have initiated a group only exclusively for Gulf region. So you can interact in that. If you have not joined that, you can request me. I'll give you the link. It's not open to all. It's only for the people from Gulf region. Okay. So we will think of a listening. We have already thought of a listening because many have asked for it. Listening is one of the easiest subtests. Whether it is here or IELTS or TOEFL, everywhere, listening is the easiest one where you can score the highest.
Okay.
But the strategical thing, as I told you, even in writing, no? The purpose, the first part, out of 5 ingredients, first part, purpose, score is between 1 to 3. Whereas all other aspects are 1 to 7. And out of 3, if you don't get 2, even if you get 7 in all the aspects, you will not get a B.
Okay. Well.
You understand? The purpose itself is not clear. That's what's happening to many people. They have written a good letter. Everything is clear, well done, perfect. But in one major ingredient, they haven't got even 2.
Mm.
Their purpose was very unclear. takes you to a C plus or C?
Surya father, Surya Chandra Kumar.
Surya, yeah. That's why I said you'll be ready to on your video at least. It will be clear when you speak to me, no? When I listen to you. Okay, what was Isbar like? If you have, did you attend my previous session? Was my question.
Yes, she attended father already.
Yeah, now the, now the thing is, it will be a bit challenging, but you if you have the screenshots, otherwise somebody can share it or I can share it. You okay, just okay. Just see what is under identification. Okay.
Okay.
What headings, side headings are under identification? What is under situation? What is under background? What are the side headings under assessment? What are the side headings under request? Identify okay. and write down those side headings. Okay?
All right, Father.
Then you try to identify whom to whom are you writing the letter.
Okay.
Okay? And only whether you have to take some point, some case note, whether you have to consider or not consider, it all depends on to whom are you writing it.
Okay.
And try to highlight and compartmentalize into ISBAR the case notes.
Sure.
I have clearly shown you in the slides there.
Yes, Father. Whenever I am writing, I will be okay in writing the I and S. When I come to the assessment part, I am a little bit confusing. Which information I would have to choose in that? That's why.
That's what I said. You don't get into writing if you are not fixed with your exams. Don't start now writing. Go into analyzing the case notes and putting them into ISBAR categories. Okay.
Okay.
ISBAR okay, categories. Father. At least the side headings. First, okay. you put the side headings. Then you try to think of whom are you to whom are you writing. If you are writing to a doctor, do you need to give the minute details?
Okay.
Like you give to a social worker. No, it's not required. So what is important? Just try to think of that. Visualize a patient coming to you.
Okay, Father.
What should you ask him? You try to create a case note by yourself, imagining, visualizing.
Okay.
You know the headings like side headings. Once you know the side headings, symptoms. Think of the symptoms. What are the major symptoms of a particular condition, disease?
Mm-mm.
You know, just write down that. Have patience and gradually. And if you can send it to me highlighted, I can give an opinion on that. Or I can correct you. That will not be a big issue.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Kavita.
Session, formal session is over.